Hello Internet! Did you ever wonder about the answers to Eritasium's new video? This is my take on his questions and four possible answers. If you haven't seen his video before, it's down in the description. Question 1. What is in the mystery cylinder? On an inclined plane, the cylinder should always roll down. I think inside the cylinder is a viscous fluid. Let's draw in the contact point and the center of mass of the fluid. Currently, the center is in front of the contact point. But as soon as the cylinder starts rolling, the fluid can't keep up and the center of mass moves behind the contact point, stopping the cylinder. Now the fluid got time to settle down. And as soon as the center of mass gets in line or even in front, the cylinder starts rolling again, repeating the process over and over. Question 2. Will the bicycle go forwards, backwards or stay in place? I think the bicycle should go backwards, depending on a few factors. To keep things simple, we only look at the back wheel and the pedal. The radius of the pedal is smaller than the radius of the wheel, and the revolution ratio between wheel and pedal is 1:1. If I pull the string on the lower pedal, both the pedal and wheel wants to move backwards. But this is impossible since both are connected and it would result in opposing rotations. The wheel traveling backwards while the pedal is moving forwards. In our case, the wheel got a larger radius and can move a longer distance than the pedal in the same amount of time. It's simply faster, making the wheel dominant and moving the whole bicycle backwards. Of course, if the gear ratio isn't 1:1 but anything higher, the pedal can become faster, moving the bike forwards. Since this problem is a little tricky to grasp, let's demonstrate it in a different way. This time, I make my pedal as long as I want it to be. When I start moving back and forth, you can see that there is a certain pivot point marked by a green dot, a place where no movement occurs. If I pull above this point, the bike moves backwards. And if I pull below, the bike moves forwards. Pulling directly at the pivot point results in no movement at all, at least from pure rotation. Question 3. How fast do you have to run the second lap to get a total average speed, which is twice the average speed of the first lap? To get the average speed of my first lap, I simply divide the distance with the time it took to complete it. To get the total average speed of both laps, I add the distance of both laps and divide it by my total time. Since the distance of both laps is the same, I can simply write it like this. And of course, the question stated that my V-total should be equal to 2 times the average speed of the first round. Now I can remove the 2 to get V1 equals lap divided by my total time. Since we know already that V1 is equal to lap 1 divided by time 1, I can write it like this. And now the problem starts. To make this equation true, I have to assume that I run the second round in a time of 0. Which also means that I need to be indefinitely fast. And that's impossible. At least I haven't tried so far. Question 4. Which part of the train is always moving backwards with respect to the ground? This would have to be the wheels of the train, since everything else is definitely moving forwards. So let's take a look at it. We got our wheels on the tracks. Once they start rotating, they are moving forwards. And I mean every part of the wheel, respectively, with the same velocity. But due to the rotation, they got an additional velocity. Forwards on the upper part and backwards on the lower. On the upper part, the velocities are simply added, and on the lower part they cancel each other out. Just think about it. The contact with the tracks is always stationary and it should not move. So this isn't our answer. But the wheels of trains got a flange, which is larger in radius than the wheel itself. These new upper and lower parts are a little faster than the actual wheel, and this extra speed is added to both points, making the new upper part go a little faster forwards, while the lower part starts moving backwards with respect to the ground. And these are my answers. I hope I'm correct. Many thanks to Eritasium for the questions. And with that being said, thanks for watching. Have a good one.